because of today's lesson. CRA lesson today is all about general revision, and today we are going to focus about this one man known as Noah. Very quickly, we shall be touching in those examinable areas about Noah, and as you all know, we will start by saying that Noah was the son.
Noah was the son of Lamech. Noah was the son of Lamech. Noah was the son of Lamech. And Noah had
three sons. Noah had three sons. These sons, their names were, number one, we start with Shem. We have Ham and Japheth. The three sons of Noah were Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Remember, Noah was 600 years old. Noah was 600 years old when God told him. Noah was 600 years old when God called him. You are asked a very simple question, that why did God call Noah? And you will say, God called Noah mainly because Noah was the only upright man during his time. This is the main reason why God called Noah. You are asked again, and I will repeat, that the main reason why God called Noah was because he was the only righteous, or he was the only upright man during his time. Then God told Noah to do what? God told Noah to build an ark. God told Noah to build an ark. Why did God tell Noah to build his ark? God told Noah to build his ark because God wanted to do what? He wanted to separate. He wanted to separate the righteous and the wicked. He wanted to separate the righteous and the wicked. Remember, when we talk about the righteous people, this was Noah and his family. These people who are wicked, these are the ones who made God do what? To destroy the world. Because during Noah's time, the main reason why God destroyed the world during Noah's time is because the world was filled with wickedness. The world was filled with wickedness, or what? Immorality. The world was filled with wickedness or immorality. You can as well talk about sexual immorality, or you can as well talk about what? Evil thoughts. This is now what made God to destroy the world. And always remember that God destroyed the world during Noah's time using what? Using floods. You can say God destroyed the world during Noah's time. God destroyed the world using floods. Remember, you should not confuse floods and fire. When you talk about fire, this was during the times of Abraham. During the times of Abraham, and when we shall be discussing about Abraham, we will also be discussing about who? Lot. And that it was in the town of Sodom and Gomorrah. This is where God destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah using what? Fire. Using fire. But God destroyed the world during Noah's time using what? Floods. Using floods. God destroyed the world during Noah's time using floods. Now, when God told Noah to build the ark, he also instructed Noah that when he is constructing the ark, he should also cover. So the ark of Noah was covered with what? With tar. The ark of Noah was covered with
Tara. Both where? Both inside and outside. The ark of Noah was covered with tar, both inside and outside. Now, after Noah finished constructing the ark, God instructed him on what he was supposed to do. He was supposed to collect a number of animals, both clean and unclean, inside the ark. And from there, God now opened the heavens and it started raining. And that's why we normally say that it rained for 40 days, 40 days and 40 nights. It rained for 40 days and 40 nights. That it took how many days? It took 150 days for the water to reduce. It took 150 days for the water to reduce. Then always remember that Noah's ark settled. Noah's ark settled on Mount what? On Mount Ararat. Noah's ark settled on Mount Ararat. We shall also be discussing majorly about the mountains in the Bible, but for now we are focusing mainly on Noah, and we've said that his ark, Noah's ark, settled on Mount Ararat. Noah's ark settled on Mount Ararat. Now, when the ark settled on Mount Ararat, Noah wanted to know the level of the water outside. So he sent two birds. Noah sent how many birds? Two birds. Now, the first bird to be sent was a raven. The first bird to be sent was a raven. This raven never went back, presumably because it found dead meat and it started eating. But again, since it never went back, Noah sent another bird, which was a dove. Remember, the dove was sent twice. The dove was sent twice. And it was during the second time when this dove went back to the ark with a what? With an olive branch or an olive tree. To symbolize that, the water had done what? The water had reduced. Now, after the water reducing and Noah settling down, he became the what? Noah became the first farmer to plant a vineyard. Noah became the first farmer to plant a vineyard. So when you ask about Noah's occupation, what was Noah's occupation? You will all always know that Noah's occupation was a farming. He was a farmer, so his occupation was a farming. So after he made some wine and drank and got drunk, then he slept naked. So his son by the name Ham, the son of Noah by the name Ham, saw his father's nakedness, started laughing and went and told his brothers. His two brothers, the brothers of Ham, who are now the sons of Noah, they came and covered their father's nakedness. So when Noah sobered up and came back to his senses and realized what had happened, He cast his son Ham alongside his grandson. Noah cast Ham, his son, alongside his grandson. Always remember, the son of Ham was known as Canaan. The son of Ham was known as Canaan. Remember, when we shall also be discussing about Moses, we'll be talking about Canaan, the name of a place. But right now, we are talking about Canaan, the son of Ham, and the grandson of who? Noah. The grandson of Noah. Remember, Noah cast Ham. The major reason why Noah cast his son Ham is because Ham saw his father's nakedness. So Ham was cast alongside his son. So, and the cast to Canaan was that Canaan now was supposed to be a slave. Canaan would be a slave to who? To Shem and who? And Japheth. Canaan will be a slave to Shem and Japheth. Now, after all this happening, Noah went into a covenant with God. And it was during this time when we learned that the kind of offering that Noah offered to God was what? Was animal sacrifice. The kind of sacrifice that Noah offered to God was animal sacrifice. And it was during this time now, when he entered into a covenant with God, where God was pleased with his sacrifice, God was pleased with Noah's sacrifice, and he promised him that never again will God destroy the world using floods, because he saw the destruction that he had caused in the entire world. Now, after God promising Noah that he will not destroy the world again, we should always remember that the sign of covenant between God and Noah was a rainbow. And this rainbow symbolized God's love. The rainbow symbolized what? God's love. The rainbow symbolized God's love. Now, God again commanded Noah. There's this command that we discussed previously, and we said that God's command to Adam and Eve, God commanded Adam and Eve to go multiply and fill the earth. But now, God's command to Noah was this, talking about God's command to Noah. What was God's command to Noah? And God told him to do what? God told Noah to have many descendants who will live all over the earth and bring it under control. This was God's command to Noah. That God's command to Noah was, have many descendants or have many children who will live all over the earth and bring it under control. Who will live all over the earth and bring it under control. Remember, this command teaches Christians, it has a very important teaching. This command teaches Christians to do what? It teaches Christians to care for God's creation. This is the main teaching of God's command to Noah. And remember, don't forget that after the flood, eight people were saved. After the floods, eight people were saved. And who are these people? We talk about Noah plus his wife. We talk about Shem plus his wife. We talk about Ham plus his wife. And we also talk about who? Japheth plus his wife. These were the eight people who were saved during the flood. We've said Noah and his wife, Shem and his wife, Ham and his wife, and also Japheth and his wife. Those were the eight people who were saved during the floods. Now, after the floods, you are also told that after the floods, of course, Noah lived for 350 years. Remember, God had called him when he was 600 years. Noah lived for additional 350 years, and later on, Noah died when he was 950 years. Noah died when he was 950 years. Now, the major lessons that we learn from the story of Noah is number one, God saves
his people. God saves his people. And number two, God punishes sinners. God punishes sinners. Those are the two greatest, or the two major lessons that we learn from the story of Noah. Having discussed all this story about Noah, remember today we were just venturing into those areas, the most examinable areas when it comes to question 62 in our KCP exam. Remember, Noah is majorly brought under number 62 in our KCP, and these are some of the areas, some of the examinable areas that you as a pupil, you are supposed to be versed with. I hope you've enjoyed my lesson. Thank you.